it's when you really break it down, these stories, that most of these stories stem from common values that we can all relate to. And that's empathy, really. You don't need to agree with it. You just need to understand it.
I think right now we're in the time that, you know, women are speaking more. They're putting their foot down. Like, if he's making this much, I have the same skills that he has. I have to be paid the same. Like, why not? What is the point of, like, if I'm doing the same, or sometimes maybe more, because we may multitask.
Exactly.
And, you know, like, you know, let's put it on the table and let's see each line in the budget and let's negotiate.
Yeah.
But you have to throw the number and you have to, you know, value yourself, because if you don't give it to you and you settle for less just for the, you know, because you're afraid of, you know, losing the opportunity or whatnot, there's more opportunities out there. And like we're saying, like, you know, we are entrepreneurs. If those opportunities don't exist, you can create your opportunities. You can build that door and then you can knock on it. You can enter yourself.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think that's important. And, you know, we have a voice, and a voice for everything, for our rights, for our money, for everything, even to tell our husband, hey, you know,
I agree. And I think a big part of why it started changing and we started talking more about it is because people started sharing their stories more.
Yeah.
And so it kind of, you know, full circle, comes back to what I really believe, which is that by sharing stories, it's not, you know, people think about it, oh, how romantic, stories. Like, no, it's not. There's a business, you know, reason for doing it. Mm-hmm. There's a therapeutic reason for doing it. There's so many reasons why you should share your stories and read other people's stories. But one of those reasons is really because everyone's story has a lesson to teach.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone's story, no matter if you relate to it, if you don't relate to it, you know, everyone's story has something to teach someone else.
So. Yeah, and it's all about the information that's also that you're putting out there. Like, for example, throughout the stories, like, people, me, I'm one that, like, when I don't know something, I'll just go to Google, and if I identify more with, like, maybe personal blogs rather than, you know, a magazine telling me a listicle or something like that, you know?
Yeah.
Like, someone that's really telling me, okay, this is how I started my business, this is how I found my funding, this is how I found, you know, like, the budget that I needed for my business and stuff like that. So, like you were saying, you know, all those, by sharing your story, that becomes kind of like an educational aspect for someone else, and then they take it from there.
And you know, I tell nonprofits this a lot. Statistics are one thing, and they're important, but they also, you know, they translate well to a certain community and to people.
Mm-hmm.
But when you implement stories into the equation, empathy is possible in many more ways. You know, you can suddenly relate to things that you didn't relate before because you heard the story. And a really kind of random example, but recently I've been kind of tapping into certain things and topics because I want stories, right?
Mm-hmm.
One of them was unjust incarceration. I was very curious about stories. And one of the things that happened to me was that in talking to somebody that had been incarcerated for many years, that had life in prison,
mm-hmm.
and then he, you know, that changed and he's great now. But he told me, you know, his story, and he kept telling me about how, you know, he started and how he was selling drugs and blah, blah, blah. And he said, you know, I know it sounds kind of maybe dumb, but I just wanted to be like my brother. And my brother was a part of the gang, and I really just looked up to him.
Oh.
And when he said this,
that's all he
I said,
knew,
you know what? That is, please don't ever think that is dumb, because I can't relate to selling drugs. I can't relate to many things that you were telling me, but I can relate to wanting to be like my brother.
Mm.
And suddenly your story just became immediately relatable and possible for me, you know? And so it's when you really break it down, these stories, that most of these stories stem from common values that we can all relate to. And that's empathy, really. You don't need to agree with it. You just need to understand it. And so that's kind of the heart of why I'm trying to get all these stories out there.
I'm sure this is a lot.
Wow.
And like, by reading all these stories, it must be a lot on you, or on people from the community. Luckily, StoryPlace has a pen name, right?
Yeah.
You don't have to share your
You have a pen name.
Name.
You can be as private as you want. I have a private account with a pen name. I have an account with my name. I share a lot of stories. I've encouraged a lot of people, especially public figures as well, to, you know, I'm like, don't close your Instagram, don't close your Twitter. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying add a layer where you're showing more of your true self. That is not interfering with your Instagram business model or whatever. You know, open an account and every once in a while share a story. And just tell your followers, hey, I shared a story. Go read it if you want. And, I mean, you know, StoryPlace is free. It's not like I'm making money off of that. But, you know, they actually start getting more engagement with their followers because they relate to them more and they realize that they're human beings that go through stuff. And, you know, I think it's a real responsibility of influencers to actually influence in positive ways. So,
and at the end of the day, like we say here in Pinkafe, is, you know, we can inspire each other with those stories. That is the reason why we started, you know, a podcast, not a TV show, is because we felt the need to tell stories that will inspire others, that will inspire us to serve a bigger purpose of, you know, delivering a message of perseverance, following your dreams, and even how to get something started. Sometimes, you know, our brains are so scattered. We're like, where do I start? What do I do? And we just are like a little idea, you know, and for example, you created something really nice. Like, I'm just gonna start by telling stories. Something that I love, it's my passion. It didn't sound like a business. Now it might become a bigger business every day without even knowing it. But at the end of the day, is the people are getting empowered, and that's what matters, I think.
Yeah, exactly.
That's really awesome.